dedicate this to our First Lady Grayson, who wanted this to happen. And you see, even though she's not here, here we are telling this story. And as I look around and we're all dressed in our African attire, we're here to honor our African heritage. It's a heritage that's rooted and was redefined by slavery. There was a new people, a new identity forged out of one of the worst human tragedies on record. But our people, they survived. They endured the hardship. They couldn't turn around. They couldn't go back. They didn't let it discourage them. They had us and the future in mind. They didn't let nobody stop them, even though they lost their lives. Don't let nobody turn you around. So now imagine with me, and come with me if you will. Let's listen to the sounds of some of the things in our mind that might have been happening on those. Transported legally, but it's estimated that 1.2 million came illegally from Africa. Those slaves, they endured the hardships, the degradation, and the humiliation, and many lost their lives. That's right. But they kept themselves encouraged. They didn't turn around. They didn't stop. They thought of us. And out of them was forged a strong cultural nation of new African American citizens. Don't you be disillusioned. This country was built off of the back and the sweat of the African and the African American. There isn't a place in this country's history where the African or the African American influence and accomplishments are not present. Even though we don't get all the recognition, we still have that history. We have a hallmark of fame. We're in science, we're in politics, we're in every area where accomplishments are. We have the three women from the NASA project.
That's right.
Katherine Johnson, Dorothy Vaughn, and we have Mary Jackson. We also have Thurgood Marshall.
Amen.
We have Ralph Bunche. We have Lynn Teen Price, an opera singer. We have our beautiful Cecily Tyson. Huh. There are so many names, I can't even say them in enough time we have here or even in the weeks to come. We have our young ones who are starting up. We have a 15-year-old young man who's named Deron Correa, and he's an advocate against the death penalty because he recognizes it's always the black male that gets it when they're incarcerated. We have a 16-year-old entrepreneur young lady by the name of Mykelia Umar, and her lemonade, Me and the Bees, is featured in Starbucks. I can't tell you the names of all of our youth, but they are representing us proud. And it's a thing where we have to understand who we are and where we have come from and to move forward into that. So don't look back. God was with the slave just as he was with the Israelites in Egypt.
That's right.
He brought them out across those seas. And don't look back. Don't turn around. Don't go back. Because as Pastor was saying, some are doing well, but because we have our stake in this country and we help build this country, this is our land of opportunity. This is where our blessings are. So we remember our history, but we're thankful for God for bringing us the way that he did. Now, religion plays an important part. It did for the slave and for the freedman. Because it gave us hope in those desperate times, hope. Now, the slave owners told us that we were the heathens, but it was their brand of religion that put us on the ships like the Amistad and sold us to the highest bidder. In 1619, the first slave ship came here. It landed in Jamestown, and they stepped out on Virginia soil. In 1620, the Mayflower, with the white settlers or European settlers, landed in Plymouth, Massachusetts. They stepped out on the Plymouth Rock, the famous Plymouth Rock. In the words of Malcolm X, we didn't land on Plymouth Rock. The rock landed on us. But our pastors, they were key in the redefining of the new African American. They led us. They gave us hope. They told us about the God of the Bible, the real God, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob and them. That's the God they told us about. They told us that he loved us and we are somebody. They also encouraged us, don't you let nobody turn you around. Our religious leaders have been on the forefront all the way from Nat Turner to Martin Luther King Jr. to our own Bishop Harry S. Grayson.
Amen.
They teach us about real freedom, not just the freedom from the whips and the chains, but freedom that will take our soul from this earth into the next with peace and with glory with God. So we honor our pastors. We listen to our pastors. We pray for our pastors because they are truly a gift from God. So ask yourself, have you turned around? Are you still marching up to freedom's land? Don't you let nobody turn you around. Where you go back.
Nobody, nobody turn me around. Turn me around.
and go back into imprisonment, amen, where you become incarcerated. Stay out them jails. Stay free. Don't you let nobody turn you around and go back into illiteracy. Go to school. Learn. Our ancestors died for us to have the opportunity to sit at the table of education. Don't you let nobody turn you around or away from your spiritual roots. Because God has been so good to us. And we have so far to go. Now, everyone in this room, especially our young ones, we are what the future generations will look back on and admire. So what are you doing? What are you accomplishing? Don't you let nobody turn you around. Life happens. If you mess up, clean it up. If you fall down, get up. Stand up. Look up. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in God. But don't you let nobody, I mean nobody, turn you around. Keep on walking. Keep on talking. Keep on marching up to freedom's land. Oh,